Hey, how are you? Today we're going to be praying about maintaining a victorious mindset. And then I'm going to also do just a little word of encouragement towards the end of this. Hey, Miss Gray, Grapevine, Texas is in the building. And I just hope and pray that you do not just listen to these lives. You do not just listen to these scriptures, you know, have your little emotional experience and then walk away. It is my hope and my prayer that you would take these scriptures and begin to apply them to your life, that you would begin to stand on them until you see the manifestation of God's promises in your life. And so we're going to go ahead and get into prayer. Father, we love you. We bless you, we praise you, and we thank you so much for your goodness and kindness towards us. Go ahead and begin to put in the comments how good your God is, how faithful he is, how kind and loving he is to you. God, we thank you for being merciful. We thank you for being wonderful. We thank you for being kind. We thank you for being just. We thank you for being the God who still sits on the throne. We thank you, Father God, that you are always in control no matter what. We thank you, Lord God, that nothing that happens on this planet called Earth catches you by surprise. Nothing changes your mind. Nothing causes your plans to be null and void, Father God, because once you have declared a thing, it shall be so. And so, God, today we rest in the fact that your word gives us promises pertaining to victory. And because your word declares that we are victorious people, because your word declares that victory belongs to us through Jesus Christ, that, Father God, we will begin to walk that way. We will begin to believe it. We'll begin, Lord God, to apply this victorious mindset to every area of our life, knowing, God, that everything we face ultimately must work together for our good, knowing, God, that everything that we wrestle with and we struggle with, in the end we win, because ultimate victory is a byproduct of our salvation, thanks to Jesus Christ. Lord, your word tells us in Revelations 1:18, I am the living one. I died, but look, I am alive forever and ever. And I hold the keys of death and the grave. Father God, we thank you that because you possess authority over death and the grave, God, there is nothing that can come our way and stop us. There is nothing that can come our way and hinder us unless we permit it to. Father, because Jesus owns the keys, that means he has the authority over death. He has the authority over grave. Whatever in our lives appears to be a dead situation, we thank you, Lord God, that the giver of life can bring life to it. Father, whatever in our life seems to be over, Father, I thank you that because Jesus has the keys of death and the grave in his hands, he is able to speak life, he is able to bring life, he is able to give life. And I thank you that because he has that power, victory belongs to us no matter what we go through. Victory is ultimately ours, God, because Jesus has the keys to death and the grave. And I'm going to encourage you, begin to put in the comments, victory is mine. And I know it's like that's a song, but it is a true statement. Because Jesus Christ died on the cross for you, victory is yours. Romans 6:7 says, for when we died with Christ, we were set free from the power of sin. Father God, I thank you that because we belong to Jesus Christ, we have been set free from the power of sin. And so that lets me know, Lord God, every struggle that we face pertaining to sin, pertaining to every weight that so easily besets us, we have been given access to victory over it. We have been given access to freedom over it. We have been given access of deliverance and redemption over it. And so, Father God, I thank you in the name of Jesus that we will begin to take on this mindset that no matter what sin comes into our life, no matter what sin we may subject ourselves to or fall into, that, Father God, Jesus died so that we may be free from it. And because our freedom is in Christ Jesus, we can have victory over that thing. It does not have to be our identity. It does not have to be our lot in life. It does not have to be what we do for the rest of our days. But God, we have been given victory through Jesus Christ. And I thank you, God, that we will begin to be victorious over sin in our lives. Begin to declare in the comments that I am victorious over sin because Jesus died for you. He has granted you access to live a life free of the power of sin, meaning that you know longer have to be controlled by this thing. It no longer has to define you. It no longer has to be part of your identity. But Christ died so that you can be free from the power of sin. So anytime the enemy of your soul tries to suggest to you that this is who you are, tries to suggest to you that you'll never get past this point, tries to suggest to you that this is what you're supposed to do for the rest of your days, you remind him that you have victory through Jesus Christ, because when he died, he set you free from the power of it. He set you free from having to live prisoner to it. And you have to decide in yourself as a child of the Most High God that if Jesus died for me to be free from sin, I'm going to live like it. Don't let the enemy of your soul keep you bound to anything that Christ died for. Father, we thank you, we thank you, we thank you that we've been set free from the power of sin, and victory belongs to us as a result of it. Then we have in Romans 8 and 31, it says, what shall we say about such wonderful things as these? If God is for us, who can ever be against us? The way we maintain a victorious mindset as believers, we decide in our hearts that we remember our God is for us. And Father, we thank you that because you are for us, nothing, Lord God, by any means shall separate us from your love. Because you are for us, Father God, everything that comes in our life has to ultimately work together for our good. Because you are for us, God, when we feel defeated, Lord God, that is an opportunity for your victory to be established in our lives. If, Lord God, we cry out to you. And so, Father God, I thank you that those of us who feel defeated, those of us who feel deflated, those of us who feel weary, those of us who are worried, those of us, oh God, that are in a space, Lord God, where victory does not currently belong to us, Lord God, from a mental standpoint. I thank you, great God, that our minds are being fortified in the word of God, and we will believe what God says about us, and that is that he is for us. That is, greater is he that is in us than he that is in the world. That is, we are more than a conqueror through Christ Jesus. That is, though 1,000 may fall at my side, 10,000 may fall at my right hand, it shall not come near my dwelling. And because I am protected, because I am provided for, because I am redeemed, because I am saved, because I am renewed, because I am restored, because I am the righteousness of God in the earth, I have victory no matter what. God, I thank you that victory belongs to your children. It is our birthright as sons of God in the earth. It belongs to us, God. And where the enemy of our soul has had us convinced that defeat is all we know, where the enemy of our soul has had us convinced that failure is all we know, that the enemy of our soul has had us convinced that disappointment is all that we know, I thank you that for those of us who apply your word to our lives, we will begin to live in victory. We will begin to see victory in ways we never experienced it before, because we put our hope in you. Father, I thank you. I bless you and I praise you, Lord God, that victory belongs to us because we belong to Jesus Christ. We thank you, Father God, for what you're doing in our lives, and we bless you for being glorified. I thank you, God, that you will give us a hunger and thirst for your word. I thank you that you will give us a hunger and thirst for your word. I thank you that you will give us a hunger and thirst for your word. So, God, that we may be renewed, so that we may be fortified, and so that we may be ready, Lord God, to, Lord, come against anything that tries to come against us. And we will do that with your word. Father, we thank you that victory is part of our birthright. We thank you, Lord God, that we were given access to it when we accepted Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. And we will no longer live as failures. We will no longer live as the disappointed. We will no longer live as the ashamed. We will no longer live as the fearful. We will no longer live as the dismayed, but we will live as the confident. We will live as the covered. We will live as the love. We will live as the victorious one. We will live, Father God, as you created us to live. God, I thank you that for those of us who grab a hold to the truth of your word and stand on it until we see it manifested in our lives, we will not be disappointed and we will not be put to shame. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen and amen. God, we thank you. We love you. We bless you. We honor you. We adore you. Nobody like you, God, in all the earth. We thank you, Father God. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. And you have to begin to, no matter what you face in this time, in 2021, no matter what you see, 2022 and beyond, no matter what, you make a decision that you stand on the promises of God. You make a decision that you believe what God's word says, and you hold fast to it until you see it manifested in your life.